Hello kids, once again welcome back in my class. I am Nisha, your mentor, and we all know that exams are gone now, and by today onwards I will start new chapters, and today I will not teach you SST. Today I will be delivering a lecture on general knowledge. So today I have brought GK and topic is pictograph. Pictograph is one of the most interesting topic for kids. So for those who those kids who don't know about this topic pictograph, let me start about the concept of pictograph. What is pictograph in itself? Actually beta, pictograph is a script, is a way of writing by using different pictures. These pictures are having their own hidden message. They are just a symbol, and each symbol is carrying a message. So how do we interpret? Fine, by taking the help of pictograph. Suppose for example, this is a star. This is a picture of star. Suppose first is the picture of star, and second is the picture of flower. So what does it mean? So let's we assume that one star equals to 5 candies, okay, and one flower equals to 4 boys, okay. So one star equals to 5 candies and one flower equals to 4 boys. So by assuming these things, then we can form questions, fine. So suppose here 1 2 3, 3 stars are there, and 1 2 3 4. So now question is that how many candies you are having, and how many boys are there. So now you will ask that, ma'am, where is the candy and where are the boys? Actually, as I have given you hint that one star equals to 5 candies and one flower equals to 4 boys, fine. So if one star equals to 5 candies, then 3 star equals to 3 into 5 equals to, there are 15 candies. Okay, next is one flower equals to 4 boys. So 4 boys, one flower, 4 and 4. 4 fours are 4 into 4 equals to 16 boys are there. Okay, so these are pictographic way of solving the problem. So example I have given you, introduction I have given you. So now let's we start this. Page number 57 is there. Everything is given on the top of this page, and these are the exercise which we need to solve. So let's we see how do we solve. So you see that oval shape equals to 25 coconut trees I am showing you. Blue circle, it means that one blue circle equals to 11 bananas. This green square box, one green square box equals to 25 banyan trees. This rectangular shape means that one rectangular shape equals to 25 mango trees, one triangle equals to 25 palm trees, one star equals to 25 neem trees. Now you see that these are the names of trees, different varieties of trees, and numbers of trees are given here. In short, suppose there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 oval shapes are there. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 1 equals to 25. 1 equals to, 1 oval shape equals to 25 trees of coconut. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 ओवल शेप्स आर देयर, इट मीन्स दैट 25 विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 6. ओके सो लेट्स वी डू इन अ रफ साइड, 25 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 6 ना, तो 6 5 जा 30, 0 एंड 3, 6 जा 12, 12 प्लस 3 150. सो हाउ मेनी कोकोनट ट्रीज आर देयर? सो इन आंसर यू विल राइट, फर्स्ट नंबर आंसर इज कोकोनट trees are how many? There are 150 trees. Okay, answers I am solving. Number of, okay, second number, how many palm trees are there in the garden? So palm trees, how many triangles are there? 1 2 3 4 and 5. Fine. See, there are 1 2 3 4 and 5. Five triangles are there. So each triangle equals to 25. One triangle means 25 trees. So 25 multiplied by 1 2 3 4 and 5. So 25 multiplied by 5. 5 5 is a 25 ka 5 and 2. 5 to the 10 and 12. 125. So number of palm trees equals to 125 trees. Okay beta, this is the way we have to solve. Third number symbol is how many banana trees. Do correction in your book that in C number how many banana trees will become, will be there. How many banana trees are there in the garden? Banana tree, how many banana tree? Banana tree symbol is this blue one. So how many trees are there? 1, 2, 3. Banana tree. So 1, 2, 3. And each circle means 11. So what will be there? 11 into 3. 11 threes are 33. Number of banana trees equals to 33 trees. Okay, beta. This is very, very easy and simple method. Fine. And D number questions, you see, how many neem trees are there in the garden? What is the sign of neem tree? Neem tree sign symbol is this star. So there are how many star? 1 and 2 star, and each star equals to 25. So 1 and 2, each star means 25 trees. So what will be there? 25 into 2 equals to 50. So number of neem tree equals to 50. Okay, this is the solving. Next is E number. E number is how many banyan trees are there in the garden? Banyan trees are these symbol, this green symbol. So 1, 2 and 3 boxes are there. 1 box, 2 box and 3 box. Each box equals to 25 banyan tree. So 25 multiplied by 3 equals to 75. Then number of banyan trees equals to 75 trees. Okay, 75 trees. So this is all about the solving of this page. Okay, I have given you the perfect solving over here. You please fill this side by looking on this board. Please complete this part. Now see, our next topic is about the inventors. It means that today we will, in this topic, we will read about different inventions, name of the inventions and their related inventors. Fine. See, so what is the first? Page number 58. Okay, page number 58. Who invented bicycle? bicycle was invented by Kirkpatrick. Yes, Kirkpatrick was the person who invented bicycle. Bicycle is a two-wheel vehicle, and it was invented for the first time by Kirkpatrick. Kirkpatrick Macmillan, you can write complete. Macmillan. Fine. Second number, who invented oxygen? Oxygen, yes, oxygen was invented for the first time by Joseph Priestley. Fine. Third number is Alaska. Who invented Alaska? Alaska was invented by Vitus Jonathan Bering. Fine. Fourth number is, who invented dynamite? Alfred Nobel. Yes, dynamite is one of the most dangerous things, and it was invented by Alfred Nobel. Got it. Fifth number is Victoria Falls. Who invented Victoria Falls? David Livingstone. Yes, who was the inventor of Victoria Falls? Sixth number is penicillin. Who invented penicillin? Penicillin was invented by Alexander Fleming. Yes, Alexander Fleming was the one who invented penicillin. Penicillin is one of the antibiotic. Who invented shorthand? Shorthand is a kind of writing, and it was firstly invented by Walter Pittman. Okay, so these are some inventions name and inventor's name. So please write down in your book. Let's we start one more new topic, and this topic is all related to computer. You know that nowadays computer is widely used in different forms, and computers are not like the old time what we were using. Nowadays computers are also being updated. Latest versions of computers we are using nowadays, because computer is that machine which makes our work easier and faster. It is found in everyone's home, in all offices. All official works are done only with the help of computer. And nowadays it is the time of online. Everything we are getting done online. So days are gone when we were standing in a queue waiting for so many things. Now everything is done online. So this is all about computer zone. So let's we see what do we learn in this chapter. First automatic calculator. See, calculator is that device which is used to calculate the mathematical terms, huh? So in olden days when there was no calculator, we used to do manually. It was time consuming, very laborious. But the time when it was invented, it made our work very, very easier. So this device is named calculator. Fine. So first, fully automatic calculator. Automatic calculator. What was the name of the automatic calculator? It was Mark First. Yes, Mark First was one of the automatic calculator. Name of the automatic calculator. Second, first calculator. Okay. Developed by Blaise Pascal. Okay, who was the developer of first calculator? Blaise Pascal was the person who invented first calculator. Third number is printed output is called hard copy. Yes, hard copy. See, this book, this book is the hard copy, and when we read this book on the screen of the computer, that is called soft copy. Soft copy means that we can read only, we cannot we cannot touch that copy, is called soft copy. And this is the copy which we can see, which we can turn, this is called hard copy. Fine. Fourth is, which device gives us soft copy? Dash device gives us soft copy. It is monitor. Yes, monitor means key, the screen of the computer. Yes, the screen of the computer. Suppose it is a computer and its screen. This is the screen. So there we can read only, the content can is readable only. So that is called soft copy. But when we get its print out, that is called hard copy. Okay, beta. Next is full form of ISP. ISP equals to internet service provider. What is the meaning of, for what is the full form of ISP? ISP means internet service provider, means the point from where service is being provided, that is called ISP, internet service provider. Father of computer. As father of computer, who is known as father of computer? Yes, it is, that is Bill Gates. Yes, Bill Gates is one of the most famous person who was known as father of computer. Next is dash is not available in font group. What is not available in font group? Font group means the way of writing, the style of writing. So what is not available? Alignment. Yes, alignment is that which makes your page like in the center, in the right one, in the left one. That is called alignment of a content, but that is not available in font group, because font is something like the way of writing, the style of writing. Next is, where does the received mails are stored? Received mails are stored in inbox. Yes, regarding the mail part, the mail is the messages what we are where we are putting, that has different sections, inbox, outbox, sent, not sent. So inbox is that part of the mail where all messages what we receive are actually stored. That is called inbox, means jo message aate hain, that is given a proper space to be stored, that is called inbox. But the part from where we send the message from our part, that is called outbox. Means the message which is sent by us is called outbox, and the message which is received by us is called inbox. So all messages which we receive is stored in a proper place, it is called inbox. First of all, you fill this part in your book. So beta, here our chapter is getting over, and apart from this you will find some more questions that I have left for you. You please try to solve yourself, because the remaining pages what we have in the book is all about the revision. So you keep solving. If you find any confusion, you can ask me, you can drop your question in the comment box. I will be coming with few more remaining pages. Till then, have a nice day.